day, grade 5 students! Welcome to science class! Before we start our online class, let's follow our online classroom rules. First, sign in or log in your account 10 minutes earlier before the start of class. Second, kindly mute your microphone unless you are asked to speak. Third, look at the screen. Fourth, listen carefully. And fifth, kindly click wave icon if you have something to share. Alright, please prepare your pencil, pen, paper, and module. Thank you! At the end of this module, you're expected to describe the parts and functions of the male and female reproductive system. Before we start, let's answer what's to look back. Directions. Choose the letter of the correct answer. Number 1. Which organ is protected by the skull? A. Brain. B. Heart. C. Intestine. D. Lungs. The correct answer is A. Brain. Number 2. How do the bones, muscles, and joints work together to help you move? The selection are A. 1, 2, 4. B. 1, 2, 3. C. 2, 3, 4. Or D. 1, 3, 4. The correct answer is letter B. Number 3. How do heart and lungs work together? A. They allow distribution of clean air to all parts of the body. B. They allow the absorption of nutrients to all parts of the body. C. They allow distribution of nutrients and oxygen to all parts of the body. Or D. They allow absorption of oxygen and nutrients to the all parts of the body. The correct answer is letter C. Number 4. Which organ works together in breaking down proteins, destroying microorganisms in food, and break down toxic substances in the blood and help in the digestion of the fatty substances? A. Stomach and small intestine. B. Stomach and liver. C. Stomach and large intestine. Or D. Stomach and esophagus. The correct answer is letter A. Number 5. What part of the body connects the bones together? A. Cartilage. B. Joints. C. Ligaments. Or D. Tendons. The correct answer is letter C. Reproduction is a process by which living things multiply their own kind. We have two kinds of reproductive system. The first one is what we call the male reproductive system, and the second one is the female reproductive system. The male reproductive system is a group of organs that makes up a man's reproductive and urinary systems. These organs do the following jobs within your body. They produce, maintain, and transport sperm and semen. And when we say testosterone, this is a male sex hormone produced by the testes. We have the main parts of male reproductive system. The first one is what we call vas deferens. Vas deferens serve as the passageway of sperm from the testes to the seminal vesicle. Number 2, we have penis. Penis is an elongated muscular organ. Number 3, scrotum. Scrotum is a sac-like structure, outer layer that hangs behind the penis and protects the testes. Number 4, epididymis. Is a narrow cold tube at the back of testicle that stores and carries sperm. Number 5. Testes. When we say testes, it produces sperm and testosterone, a male hormone. The male reproductive system has various organs. It has scrotum, testes, and penis. It also includes vas deferens, urethra, prostate gland, and seminal vesicles. Males have billions of sperm cells in their testes. Penis is full of blood vessels and nerves. Semen is a whitish fluid nourishes the sperm. Testes produce sperm and testosterone, a male hormone. And scrotum protects the testes. Now let's answer what's more to do. Directions. Study the illustration below. Label the parts of the male reproductive system. Choose the correct answer inside the box. Write your answer in your answer sheet. Are you ready? I'm giving you 1 minute to answer the activity. You may click the pause button to pause the video while the pupil is answering his or her activity. Now let's answer another activity from What's More to Do. Directions. Supply the missing words. Choose the correct answer inside the box. The main organs of the male reproductive system are the gland that produces blood. The correct answer is testes and sperm cells. Next one. Testes are in a sac of skin called gland that provides a cool place where the testes can produce a healthy sperm. The correct answer is scrotum. Next one. Produced sperm from the testes is stored in the epididymis, which is connected to gland. The correct answer is vas deferens. As the sperm passes through the vas deferens, it is nourished by fluids released by the accessory glands, which are the gland and bladder. The correct answer is prostate glands and seminal vesicle. Next one. The fluids also lubricates the epididymis, vas deferens together with the sperm form semen. And the semen passes through the tube called gland, from which it is expelled through that opening in the gland. The correct answer is penis and urethra. Now let's discuss the different parts of the male reproductive system and their specific functions. The first one is what we call penis. The penis is the external male organ with a tip called glans. It is covered with a foreskin that may be removed through circumcisions. Next one is what we call scrotum. The scrotum is a pair of pouch-like sacs that contains the testes. It controls the testes temperature because they may be slightly cooler than the body to produce sperm cells. Next one is testes. Testes are glands that produce sperm cells and male sex hormone called testosterone. Epididymis is a narrow, cold tube that stores sperm cells. And urethra in males is the passageway of both urine from urinary bladder and semen from the glands. We also have seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle are sac-like pouches attached to the vas deferens. It contributes to the semen production. Vas deferens. Vas deferens is a long muscular tube that serves as the passageway of sperm cells released from the testes. Cowper's gland, one of the two pea-sized organs found beneath the prostate gland, it is responsible for releasing fluid that flushes out foreign matters and neutralizes the acidic urine in the urethra. Prostate gland is located between the bladder and the penis. It produces fluid that nourishes and protects the sperm. Directions. Answer the question briefly. What are the parts and functions of the male reproductive system? Now let's proceed to the female reproductive system. When we say the female reproductive system, it is designed to carry out several functions. It produces the female egg cell necessary for reproduction, called the ova or oocytes. The system is designed to transport the ova to the site of fertilization. And we also have estrogen, which is a female sex hormone produced by ovaries. Now let's define the different parts of female reproductive system. The first one is we have fallopian tube. The fallopian tubes are the thin soft tubes extending from the uterus to ovaries. Fertilization can occur in these tubes. Second one is what we call uterus. Uterus is a hollow, pear-shaped organ. It has a muscular wall and lining. It nourishes and houses a fertilized egg. It is where the fertilized egg implants, grows, and develops. The third one is what we call cervix. The cervix is located in the lower portion of the uterus. It opens into the vagina and it allows the flow of menstrual blood and it expands to allow the passage of the baby to the vagina. We also have ovaries. Ovaries are the female reproductive organs that produce egg cells. They also make estrogen and progesterone, kinds of sex hormones for females. Vagina. Vagina is the outside passageway of the baby, which is also called as the birth canal. Now let's answer what will I do? Directions. Study the illustration below. Label the parts of the female reproductive system. choose the correct answer inside the box. Number 1. The correct answer is fallopian tube. Number 2. Ovary. Number 3. Cervix. Number 4. Uterus. And number 5. Vagina. Are you ready? I'm giving you 1 minute to answer the activity. You may click the pause button to pause the video while the pupil is answering his or her activity. Now let's answer a short activity from What's More to Do. Directions: identify the part of the female reproductive system being described. Choose the letter of your answer inside the box. Number 1. Produces egg cells as well as female sex hormones. The correct answer is letter E. Number 2. A hollow muscular organ located at the lower abdomen. The correct answer is letter C. Number 3. Leads the egg cells from the ovary to the uterus. The correct answer is letter A. Number 4. Serves as a birth canal of the newborn baby. The correct answer is letter B. Number 5. Located at the lower parts of a uterus. The correct answer is letter D. Good job! Let's answer a short activity from What Else Can I Do? Directions: put a check if the reproductive part belongs to a female, male, or both. Number 1. Fallopian tube. The correct answer is female. Number 2. Testes. The correct answer is male. Number 3. Ovary. The ovary is from female. Number 4. Cervix. The cervix is from female. Number 5. Penis. Penis is from male. And number 6. Uterus. The correct answer is female. Number 7. Vagina. The correct answer is female. Number 8. Vas deferens. The correct answer is male. Number 9. Epididymis. The correct answer is male. Number 10. Urethra. The correct answer is both. Now let's answer a short activity from What's More to Do. Directions: give the functions of each part of the female reproductive system listed below. Female part. Number 1. Ovaries. Number 2. Fallopian tube. Number 3. Uterus. Number 4. Cervix. And number 5. Vagina. Are you ready? I'm giving you 1 minute to answer the activity. You may click the pause button to pause the video while the pupil is answering his or her activity. For your last activity, try the answer "How's my target now?" Directions: choose the letter of the correct answer and write your answer before the number. Are you ready? I'm giving you 1 minute to answer the activity. You may click the pause button to pause the video while the pupil is answering his or her activity. After studying and answering the modules, the parents will return it to the school using Dropbox. Please follow the schedule of distribution and retrieval of modules. Thank you! Before we end this video, I would like to say thank you for watching and I hope you learn a lot. Study hard and achieve your goals. See you in our next video lesson. Goodbye!